talk about the definition of dogs of war. So tactical dogs, dogs for military purposes. These dogs started out as molosses, but have gradually developed more into the shepherd type of dogs. And I will tell you why, and also what has been changed. So first of all, why were the first dogs of war more of a molosser type? The purpose of these type of dogs were, to say very bluntly, cannon fodder and also to deal with other animals. So what do I mean in this this context? Dogs were used to combat cavalry, so people that brought their horses and were a pest to the infantry, so the people on foot, because they would have enormous impact, would travel fast, and would just flank and pierce through those infantry troops. And what they did is they used dogs, and they put either fiery pots on their back and sent them in. So then they walked under the horses. The horses feel the flames and would just go on the back legs and throw off the riders. Another option would be that the dogs would carry spikes on their backs or blades with a similar purpose, to cut open the horses from underneath or their legs, and that also would render them unusable. Very often these horses had armor, and the underbelly was often easier to be targeted, as well as the legs. Another thing is that they also use these dogs to have hand-to-hand combat, or dog-to-infantry especially combat, and they would just have to fight. So either by attacking those horses, you should have a decent size and also decent strength to cut them open or carry those fire pots, but also in the context of hand-to-hand combat, you need a strong dog to be a man-stopper. So as we discussed, one of the properties would be strong dog, which the molosses are, very strong dogs, but also a very brave dog, because even horses oftentimes did not want to go into combat. And you need a certain type of dog that will go into the fire, blood, screams, and also the big animals and just charge in. And therefore they use this molosser type of dogs, which are next to very big, also very brave. And they were called dogs of war. These are the similar types of dogs that are also used in combat in, for example, arenas like the Colosseum, and also were there to just deal with humans. And how did they deal with humans? It's a man-stopping ability, so they would jump up and throw the human to the ground, and then ground and pound upon them. A similar way was used against the Indians by the Spanish conquistadores. And derivatives thereof are still being used. There, for example, the Vila Brasileiro still carries that blood to a high degree. So big type of molosser, hound type of dog that could sniff them out if needed. This is different than the standard dogs of war, that were not that much of a sniffing dog, just thrown in and normally would not survive, so they would be trampled upon and dealt with as soon as possible, because they were faster than infantry, for example, and they would just charge in and also very often die. Therefore they did not have the need of enormous amount of interaction between dogs and also human soldiers. So the shepherd type of characteristics were not as much needed. in their time. Whereas the modern day Villa Brasileira was also developed out of this dogs of war, but also with more sniffing ability to catch dogs that were hiding or fleeing, and to also bring them to a halt. That being said, that was the origin of the war dog. Also, there were other roles for war dogs, for example, communication, and that it would be nice to have a smaller type of dog or faster type of dog. But we can skip that. We just stick to the regular type of tactical dogs. And in this day and age, it has evolved from this molosser type of dog to a herding type of dog. But not an actually herding type of dog. It's descendants of originally herding types of dogs, but they are now more of a tactical, military, police type of dog. So, for example, the German Shepherd dog. But that dog was very popular also in tactical operation, but has now been surpassed completely by two dog breeds. One is the Malinois, which is a Belgian herder, but also the Dutch Shepherd, which is a Dutch herder. And especially the smooth-coated varieties are the most used tactical dogs in this day and age. And there's something else going on. Again, they are adding combat genes to make them more dependable, more robust, and also increase their bravery to a high degree. And they do not use normally molosser type of blood, but they do use Bull and Terrier type of blood. And the Bull and Terrier, you can see as a further evolvement of the molosser, but in the smaller size, even braver, better combat. Better combat characteristics, but in a far smaller and nimbler body. And these Bull and Terriers are now added to herder blood. Oftentimes denoted as Malinois X or Dutch Shepherd X, next to some German Shepherd blood that's also infused, and sometimes some other blood like Goedemeler, which is also Belgian Shepherd. It's like a darker colored, long haired nephew of the Malinois. And the thing is, if you're breeding for performance, normally you will line breed and interbreed, and very often time you can also inbreed depression. One source to deal with this is to go out to a related type of dog, the Morga, and then the German Shepherd dog would bring also a bigger stage to deal with the high inbreeding in the past. So the high inbreeding would also lead to smaller dogs, and you need a certain size. But nowadays, more and more you see that the Bull and Terrier blood is introduced. And that those crosses are predominantly herders, so herding breeds like Malinois and Dutch Shepherd, but also carry a degree of Bull and Terrier blood, which can make up to 25% in some performance lines, but are often more diluted. And it should be said that if the modern tactical dogs, especially the Dutch Shepherd, already carried more bull blood as compared to the Malinois, so a little bit lower to the ground, so lower weighted withers and more massive build, also less less frantic, so to say, than the Malinois, which can be quite nervous in the hands of police, which would lead, and in military hands, which could lead to also attacking their own forces. This, of course, is not the thing that they want. Otherwise, they would have opted for a different type of breed. Also, the benefit of Bull and Terrier blood is, of course, being pure fighting blood. They don't get stressed out
they can deal with the
enormous pressure, and they have high courage, high fighting ability, even in a small package. And if they are kept to be small, they can also easier wriggle themselves to small places to attack their opponent. The thing is that next to this normal features, also sometimes now dogs are used for sniffing or patrolling, sniffing for drugs or weapons, also bombs. They lead to big tactical advantages, but also the ability to patrol and have more heightened senses of smell and sight at your disposal is a very good thing, of course. So that brings you to the modern day tactical war dog, which is also used by police forces. Hope you like this video. If you do, feel free to subscribe and like. It helps me a lot. Have a great day.